Good morning, students. So we keep talking about the information contained in sample about the parameter. So let us try to put things together properly. So you might have studied the concept of indexing parameter when you studied probability distributions in the previous semester. So suppose we have a random sample from a probability distribution where a real valued parameter is the indexing parameter. So suppose fx theta is the probability distribution. So it can be either a continuous distribution or can be a discrete distribution, can be a mixture. So anything. So suppose f denotes that probability distribution and x is the associated random variable or random vector. So the only thing which we assume is that theta here, that is the indexing parameter, is in the parameter space, which is a subset of proper or improper subset of real line. So in short, theta is real valued. So we call so here I have tried to explain why we call theta as indexing parameter. So we call theta as the indexing parameter because as theta changes, the shape of this function f or the scale or the location or similar other features which can be recognized easily change, and so theta becomes the indexing parameter with related to this probability distribution. So now we may want to compute the rate at which this change in f happens as the values of theta change over the parameter space. So now is it possible to compute such rate for every probability distribution, or do we need certain conditions? So yes, certain conditions are needed, such as the support of the distribution, probability distribution, should be free from theta, because if it is dependent on theta, then the measures which we are going to develop to measure this information, they may not work at all. So such as differentiation of this PDF with respect to the parameter may not be possible if the support itself depends on theta. So such to avoid all such issues, the support is assumed to be free from theta and parameter space is also assumed to be open. So under such conditions, it is possible to measure the change through differentiation of the PDF with respect to theta. So suppose these two conditions are satisfied, so suppose the support is free from theta, then this quantity, the partial derivative of f with respect to theta, it will give you, now you know the interpretation of derivative, first order derivative. So it is nothing but the rate of change or rate at which the function changes with respect to the change in the quantity with respect to which we are differentiating. So here we are differentiating f with respect to theta. So the interpretation will be that the rate, this is nothing but the rate at which f changes with respect to theta. Now you are going to compute it. See, f is going to be calculated at point x. So f at point x. So this rate will be at this point x. So this quantity, when if you divide this entire by the value of the PDF at that point, then this will be the relative rate. Why do we need this ratio? So see, another way to interpret this is, okay, suppose this is the change, this is the rate at which it is changing, but how much was the value when this much was the change? This question may arise. So the answer to this question is provided by this ratio. So this ratio gives you the relative rate of change in f with respect to the changes in theta at the point x. So both these quantities, now this one and this one, they are, means the derivative itself is a random variable, f is going to be a random variable. So both these quantities are random variables, and so the ratio is a random variable. So just this value we cannot consider, this ratio we cannot consider as a measure, because it, as you change x, it is going to change then. So different values of x will give you different values of the information, and that is not what one wants. When you say a measure, it should, the measure should be a single quantity which is connected with the f and not something which changes as you change x. So instead of looking at the all these, we consider the average value, and so we consider the expectation of this ratio. So this can also be written as dabi f by dabi theta upon fx theta, and its expectation with respect to again the PDF f. So notice that this is nothing but the derivative of logarithm of the PDF with respect to theta. So this is how the logarithm of PDF comes into picture here. So this quantity can be viewed as a way to measure the information contained in the variable, random variable x, with respect to or about the parameter theta. So here is the formal definition now. So suppose x is a real or vector valued parameter, vector valued random variable. Please make this correction. This should be this quantity. This should be a random variable. Okay, so with PDF or PMF, fx theta. So theta is in the parameter space, which is subset of real line. Assume that this s theta now is independent of theta, and the PDF is such that the differentiation with respect to theta under the integral sign in the identity integration fx theta equal to 1 for every theta in the parameter space is valid at least twice. What does it mean? It means that when you differentiate this equation with respect to theta, then that differentiation is possible at least twice. So under these two conditions, we can define the Fisher information. So let us see how it can be done. So the Fisher information, then it will be expectation, as I explained you, it is. See, we were considering, let me go back and explain a bit more. See, this was one way to measure, but do you realize that this derivative can be positive or negative? So suppose we want to give equal weightage to the positive and negative values, means we want to consider only the magnitude. So one way to do that is consider the absolute value of this quantity, or means expectation of absolute of this, or another way is consider the square and then take the expectation. So we go for the second option and we consider the square. So here is the Fisher information. It is expectation of dabi f by dabi theta square. So which is nothing but expectation of dabi log f by dabi theta whole square. So now can we show that this is same as this, or can we get a simpler expression? This is same as this, this is obvious. But can we get a simpler expression for this? Let us try to find that. So let us consider this quantity, the second assumption or the second regularity condition needed for defining Fisher information. Notice that when you are dealing with the discrete random variable, then instead of integration you will have summation. So it's not necessary that you can define Fisher information only for continuous random variable. You can compute it for discrete random variable as well. Then this condition, instead of integration, you will have the summation sign there. So we are dealing with the continuous case, but similar results can be derived for the discrete cases as well. So this, consider this integration, then differentiate this with respect to theta. So because this derivative, because of the second assumption, that differentiation is possible within the integral sign. So now let me explain this here. Why do you need the support to be free from theta? That will be clear to here. Suppose you are dealing with uniform 0 theta, then the range of the integration will be 0 to theta. And now suppose you are trying to differentiate this quantity, this quantity with respect to theta. What will happen? The upper limit is theta itself. So how can you take the differentiation within the integration? You can't, no? Because this entire quantity, unless you evaluate the integration, you won't be able to differentiate. And so to be able to take the differentiation inside the integration, this support should not depend on theta. So that is how the first condition has arrived. So suppose you are able to differentiate, then you will have this dab f by dab theta dx will be 0. Alright, now suppose I multiply and divide this by the PDF f, then you will have this. So now this quantity becomes dab log f by dab theta, and so you have this integration 0, because derivative of 1 will be 0. So the right hand side is 0. Now, so see, this is true for every theta in the parameter space. And so as a result, now once you fix theta, you choose one value of theta, then this becomes a random variable. So for every fixed value of theta, this term, all the time, this term is going to be a random variable. So this equation 1 means that expectation of this dab log f by dab theta is 0. Now how can we extend this further? So now if you differentiate this equation 1 again with respect to theta, you get this. Now you have two functions of theta here, this one and this one. So apply the chain rule of differentiation to get this. So the first will be, quantity will be second order partial derivative of log f with respect to theta, and the second will be dab log f by dab theta dab f by dab theta dx. Again, this dab f by dab theta you can adjust as 1 upon f dab f by dab theta into f. And so again you get dab log f by dab theta here. See, in the second term if you consider, you can simplify it like this. And so finally you get integration of dab log f by dab theta whole square fx theta dx, which is nothing but expectation of this quantity. And so the first term, so finally you have got this. So this you can take, or this you can take to the right hand side. And so finally you get expectation of dab square log f by dab theta square is expectation of minus of this. So usually this minus sign is kept here. And so the Fisher information finally becomes this. Expectation of minus dab square log f by dab theta square, or expectation of dab log f by dab theta whole square. So how do you read this symbol? So this quantity indicates the Fisher information contained in the random variable x about the parameter theta. So this is how one should read this. So there are some minor results associated with Fisher information. So we will go through them very quickly. So if you have a random sample from probability distribution, then the information contained in the entire sample is n times the information contained in a single random variable. Then one more result is there, that if t is a sufficient statistic for theta, real valued theta, then the Fisher information contained in t is same as the Fisher information contained in the entire random sample. So this is one important result. Now let us quickly go through an example. So suppose you have a random sample from Poisson distribution. So see, this is the discrete setup. Then the PMF is this, the support is this. So free from theta parameter space is open. Now this is a member of exponential family. So already these conditions are satisfied. Now let us consider log f. So it is like this, minus theta plus x log theta minus log x factorial. So if you differentiate this, you get this as the derivative. And so if you take the expectation, see, finally you get the Fisher information as 1 by theta. And so the Fisher information contained in the sample will be n by theta. Now let us try to verify whether the minimal sufficient sufficient statistic has the same information or not. Now in case of Poisson, summation xi is sufficient for theta. Now it follows Poisson distribution with parameter same theta. So write the PMF of Poisson distribution, consider the log, differentiate it, then again differentiate it and compute the Fisher information. So you will find that the Fisher information is n by theta. So actually this is not the proof, this is a verification, just verification of the result. So yes, you saw that Fisher information is in the sufficient statistic is same as the Fisher information in the entire sample. So this is how sufficiency actually is an important concept if you consider the angle of or the measure of Fisher information. Still, sufficiency can be justified. Now consider another example, normal theta 1. You can try solving this. Try to find the Fisher information contained in the variable x with respect to the parameter or about the parameter theta. So here is the remark. So Fisher information, this way I have already mentioned, Fisher information is not applicable to the distributions where the range of the random variable depends on the parameter, for example uniform 0 theta. In short, whenever support depends on theta, then Fisher information cannot be defined for such distributions.